We spend our entire careers building expertise. Let me get this going here. Ah, there we go. And it's because we believe this widely, It's because we believe this widely accepted notion that if we build experience over time, this will result in expertise, which will result in success. This is a big, fat illusion. Imagine you're a content marketing expert. Probably not hard for most of you in this room. Well, that used to mean something, but now there's over 11 million search results for content marketing experts on Google, and on LinkedIn alone, 3.5 million content marketing experts. Want a white paper written by a content marketing expert? Awesome, you have 22 million to choose from. You get where I'm going. We are building expertise in a world overpopulated by experts. And maybe you're thinking, no, no, but I'm gonna really niche mine down and get to be known for this, you know, real specific expertise. Look, we live in a world where there's 700,000 cuddling experts and cuddling conventions. You cannot niche your way out of this. We have to stop contributing to expert overpopulation. Not only is it a slow grind, but it's actually taking us in the exact opposite direction of where we wanna go. Let me show you. This is the Amplify matrix. We're gonna walk through it together. So on this side of the matrix, let's look at the x-axis together, is accepted, right? Very generally recognized or believed things. All the way on the other side is challenge, things that question the conventional wisdom. On the y-axis, way down here, we have how-to, very detailed, practical advice. And all the way on the top, we have how to think, something that actively forms a new approach. Now, you can chart anything that you're doing on this axis, on this matrix. Your speech, your book, your next blog post, your next podcast episode, any content that you're publishing, you can plot on this. And for the purpose of today, since we only have 12 minutes, we're gonna focus on the two most important quadrants of the Amplify matrix. This accepted how-to area, what I call Expertville, and this how-to-think challenge quadrant, which we'll call Visionary Town. So let's start in Expertville. For fun, I looked at the Content Marketing World Agenda, and I started plotting the sessions here. And I started plotting all the sessions that fit in this Expertville category, meaning content that is detailed practical advice about generally recognized or believed things. And it looks like this. How-to content. You can't get much more how-to than that. Creating an influence marketing strategy, A to Z, how to build and maintain an audience with a remarkable email newsletter. And on it filled. In fact, about 90% of the agenda fits into Expertville. Now, I'm not knocking this content. This is good, useful content. These are great speakers, and they probably run successful businesses. But the point that I want to show is that Expertville is crowded. It is really hard to stand out, and because of the crowding, your content does get commoditized. The other thing is, your audience doesn't think they need you, because if you're doing your job and how-to on stuff they know they need to be doing, they think, thanks for all the tips and tricks. I can do this. All right, let's look across the pond to Visionary Town. I did the same thing, plotted some sessions that fit into Visionary Town, meaning content that actively forms a new approach by questioning conventional wisdom. And this is what it looked like. Be the exception. Jay Akunza's wonderful keynote earlier yesterday morning, all about following intuition to stand out in a world full of average. Becoming an audience company, Robert Rose's keynote yesterday afternoon, all about redefining audiences and making new markets. Also note that both of these were main stage keynotes, which is not coincidental. So this is what Visionary Town looks like. It's way less crowded. By default, you're unique because nobody has the same, exact same vision as you. And your audience knows they need you because you've got them going, wow, wait a minute, you've got me rethinking my strategy or my entire business model or my company mission. I'm ready to change, tell me more. And in the center of this matrix, we have the crossroads, which everyone has to cross through to get to Visionary Town. Now, the exciting thing is that no matter where you are on the matrix, you can jump to the crossroads just by starting to ask the challenging how to think kinds of questions. But it all comes down to what you want to build. Because experts build lists. They do build lists, and they do a good job of it. But visionaries build legacies. So you didn't think you were going to get the secret to success today, but I'm going to give it to you because you guys all seem like wonderful people. Instead of being an expert, become a visionary. So how do we do that? Well, let's walk through somebody's journey and see what we can learn from her. Our story starts way down in Expertville. Meet Mel Robbins. Mel graduated from Boston College Law. She became a criminal defense attorney and became a commentator on CNN and other news channels. She did this for over a decade. She was a bona fide legal expert. After years of doing that, she started rebranding herself as more of a relationship expert and started building her expertise among women. She would start speaking at women's conferences, things like how to empower yourself in the workplace and how to grow your confidence and how to lose weight and how to communicate with your spouse. And she built herself a little niche there and did this, you know, for about another decade. She launched a website that was all about helping women feel happier. And so here you can start to think, see that she's thinking about maybe starting to shift the way some people think and view things. And then she launched her first book, Stop Saying You're Fine. And this is where she's starting to question some conventional wisdom. You say you're fine, but you're not really fine, and maybe we're all living these lives of self-accepted mediocrity. Then Mel gave her TEDx talk. Raise of hands, has anyone seen this TEDx talk? Okay, a few. It's one of the most watched TEDx talks. But this is a pivotal moment for another reason. This represents Mel's crossroads moment. And the reason why is because she starts asking a very different type of question here. So she's still positioned as a relationship expert, but look at her talk, how to stop screwing yourself over. All of a sudden, she's asking a question, is it us? Are we the problem? Are we getting in our own way? This is the first time she starts asking questions that she doesn't necessarily have the answers for. Now, in this TED Talk, she throws a bunch of stuff out there, and this was one of many things that came out of it. She started talking about one of the ways that she was screwing herself over was continuously hitting the snooze button, something probably a lot of us can relate to. So she came up with this silly little hack to count backwards from 5, and then she would launch herself out of bed. And this was just one of the many tweetable moments that came from the talk. But this was the one that started resonating with people. And people really grabbed onto this. And so Mel, like, grabbed it by the cojones and became Mel Robbins, change your life in 5 seconds. And she started challenging people to use this hack in different areas of their life, and it sparked a movement. And Mel took it all the way. She launched the 5-second rule, her book, earlier this year, which became an immediate international bestseller. And she started speaking all over the world. And right now, Mel is the number one female motivational speaker in the world. She went from facing bankruptcy early in her career to making $5 million a year in speaking fees alone. She's launched online courses, she's getting into live events next year, and she is officially in the billionaire visionary category. I mean, look at this. Mel spent 20 years down in Expertville, and her trajectory from the crossroads up to Visionary Town was about 3. And it had nothing to do with the specific expertise that she had built in Expertville. So how can we learn from this so that we don't spend years in the slow grind in Expertville? Well, Mel's success journey is easily broken down into three very distinct pieces. One is the TEDx talk when she stopped, when she gave up having to know the answers to everything and just started asking the questions. She became an authentic investigator. And this is all about being the guide, not the guru. You don't need all the answers, just ask the questions. The second was this. This was 8 seconds out of her 18-minute talk, and she almost didn't say it. She almost forgot to say it. Watch this little clip from her talk.
So everything I do, okay, this is the last part, sorry. So one more thing that you can use. I call it the 5-second rule.
She almost didn't say it. And she glosses over it at best. In fact, later she said, I never intended to tell anyone because it was stupid. So often what we think is the big idea ends up not being the big idea. And the only way she found out was she aerated it. Any ideas or solutions that you have in your head, it's a hypothesis. We have to be able to aerate it to see what resonates with people. And lastly, she stripped everything down to the 5-second rule and amplified what worked. Look, we're content marketers and we fall in love with our content. But we have to be willing to give up the stuff that doesn't work and simplify it down to what does. So give up the illusion that you need to build expertise in this world. You don't. You simply need to be willing to ask the questions that others won't. Investigate a problem. Find the answers and frame a hypothesis. That is your jump to the crossroads. Then aerate your ideas and amplify what works. That's the difference between expert and visionary. And it all starts with investigating a question. What question can you ask that Google can't answer? That's my challenge to you to start your journey there. I'm Caroline Nuttall. Thank you very much.